$4 million in hallucinogenic drugs now off the streets. Deputies say they busted two men for making the rare psychedelic drug DMT in the garage of a Wake Forest home. Good evening, I'm Marius Payton.
And I'm Angela Taylor. DMT is a naturally occurring psychedelic. It's not as popular, as well known as LSD, but its use has grown over time.
New at 6, CBS 17's Holden Kowicki is getting answers about the drug and the dangers it could pose. Holden.
Well, Maurice, there have only been three busts of DMT in North Carolina history, but one study of the drug made users feel like they were surrounded by Santa Claus and his elves. That's why I'm told it was so important to get this drug off the streets and shut down this cookhouse.
When we opened the area that the DMT lab was at, it just was you just knew what it was, and it was overwhelming.
Speaking on a condition of anonymity, this Wake County narcotics detective recounted making one of the largest busts in state history of a drug many people have never heard of, DMT.
It's actually been around for a very, very long time. It's a Schedule I narcotic, and that carries serious time. We see a lot from the younger crowd, hippie types.
In this case, detectives believe DMT was being put into vape pens.
The biggest concern are the chemicals and the oils that are going into the pens.
Unlike other inhalables, DMT provides a different kind of high.
The DMT is a hallucinogen, so you're probably not going to see somebody smoking DMT, you know, walking down the street.
The most dangerous part of the drug?
Probably the manufacturer process of the drug. You know, it's clearly a lot of volatile chemicals that are involved in making it.
Those chemicals can linger in cookhouses, so the best advice this detective can offer:
stay away from it. If you stay from inside the house, you're probably good, but clearly anytime that you're mixing chemicals and things of that nature, it's gonna be dangerous. You just never know.
And I'm told the FBI actually sent a crew out to clean up that cooking operation, which is actually a similar cooking process to making meth. Now, that is information that a realtor must disclose to any potential buyers down the road by state law. Live in Wake Forest, Holden Kowicki, CBS 17 News.